Good morning, brothers and sisters in Christ.
主内弟兄姐妹，大家早上好。
Thank God and thank the worship team that has led us in a wonderful time of worship.
谢谢敬拜团队带领我们有一段很好的敬拜。
Before I bring to you the word of God, just an announcement, especially those online. Very sorry to say that the internet is down, so go back to the Facebook under FCC. You will have the one online on the phone on from my phone. Okay.
在没有分享今天的讲道之前呢，请大家注意，尤其是在家看直播的人。
So yeah, still. So you just kind of close the old one, and then you just open a new one, and you'll be able to watch us online back.
所以呢，你们现在可以回去那个 FCC 的那个主页，然后在那边呢，你们会看到另外一个连接，你们从那边才可以看到。
Let us commit this time to God.
我们把时间交给神。
God, our gracious Father, we want to thank you that we can come into your presence this morning.
主，我们感谢你，因为我们能够今天早上来到你的同在中。
Thanking you, Lord, that you still are sovereign over everything in our lives.
感谢神，在我们生命中你还是权威的。
Even right now, despite the internet down, but we praise you that we can still continue on with the availability of other broadband.
即使是现在那个网际网络非常的慢，可是我们还是有用别的方式能够继续的要这个直播。
We pray, O Lord, that you continue to bless us and meet with us even right now in the name of Jesus Christ.
主啊，就如这个时候，你继续的跟我们在一起。
We pray this in Jesus' name.
奉主耶稣的名。
Amen.
Amen.
As we turn to the Word of God.
我们继续来看好神的话。
Let me ask you a question.
让我来先问你一个问题。
About our experience in life.
在我们生命中的经历。
Have you ever come across a situation where you hope and hope and that is all you could do?
你有没有经历过呢？一阵子就是你只能够期盼，期盼，什么事都不能做了。
I'm sure you do, right?
我相信你已经有经历过。
And you feel just helpless and you are uncertain what is going to happen to you next.
你觉得很无助，你不晓得未来会发生什么事。
If you have your Bible, turn with me to Acts chapter 23, verses 23 to 35. And this is exactly, probably, how the Apostle Paul felt at this time.
请翻开圣经《使徒行传》第23章23节到35节，这就是保罗所经历的情况。
He already heard about the ambush upon his life.
他已经听到说其他人在埋伏着要陷害他。
And he already sent the man who has given him the info, his own nephew, to the tribune.
他已经把他的派他的外甥呢去找那个千夫长。
With 40 men waiting for him with a sense of zeal that they made an oath to be accursed of God and not taste any food before Paul died.
知道说这四十个人呢是要一定是誓言是要拿下保罗，不然他们就不吃不喝。
So what is left for Paul is just to wait, hope, and see what happened next.
所以保罗当时的情况呢，就是只能够期盼，在等待下一步会发生什么事。
But this experience is really a turning point in Paul's ministry because it's going to be the beginning of a very long journey.
可是，在对保罗的事工来说呢，却是一个开始，因为是一个开一个很长的旅途的开始。
And this journey will kind of end up him in Rome and ultimately.Facing Caesar himself.
这个旅程呢，就会最终带他去到罗马去见凯撒。
So the Jesus prophecy that Paul would be a witness for him in Rome will be coming into fruition.
也就是说呢，耶稣之前的预言说保罗会去到罗马为他做见证的预言将会实现了。
So let's look at the passage this morning.
所以我们来看看今天的经节。
So in verse 23 of chapter 23,
使徒行传第二十三章二十三节。
And he says here, then he called two of the centurions and said, "Get ready, 200 soldiers with 70 horsemen and 200 spearmen to go as far as Caesarea at the third hour of the night."
千夫长便叫了两个百夫长来。两个百夫长来说，预备步兵200，马兵70，长枪手200，今夜亥出往撒加利亚去。
So there will be about 470 of them.
就是470个人。
And then he says, also provide mounts for Paul to ride and bring him safely to Felix, the governor.
也要预备牲口，叫保罗骑上，护送到巡抚腓利斯那里去。
In this story, we see two very important truths of God being in action.
这里呢，我们可以看到两个神的真理变成了行动。
The first one being the providence of God.
第一呢，就是神的眷顾。
In our Christian journey, this is one truth that we will constantly experience the providence of God.
在我们基督徒的生命中呢，我们时常都会经历到神的眷顾、神的供应。
And how is providence seen?
神的眷顾呢，是在哪方面给我们看到呢
？Each of us have some very unique experience on the providence of God.
我们相信每个人都有自己的独特的经历，经历到神的供应。
But right here in Paul's life, it was a provision unexpected.
可是呢，在保罗来说呢，这一次的供应呢是出乎意料的供应。
You know, Paul's life was simply not safe anymore in Jerusalem.
保罗的生命呢，在耶路撒冷已经不安全了。
You know, the Roman governor who was trying Paul's case.
在罗马的兵呢，他们是那个他们要审保罗的这一个事情。
He kind of couldn't get to the bottom of it because this guy seems innocent, yet the accusation was very fierce.
他们呢找不出真正事情的真相，他们。不能够定他罪，可是呢，其他人却很强烈的要定他罪。
You know, each time I read the book of Acts, I begin to think of Malaysia. I see, someone is also having the similar experience in Malaysia.
每次我读《使徒行传》的时候呢，有时候就会想到马来西亚的情况。
And now that we know that the Jews here are trying or plotting to assassinate Paul.
现在我们知道说犹太人呢想要谋杀保罗。
So the Roman commander had to get him out of the city.Safely.
所以那个罗马兵政府的人呢就要把保罗带出来。
So the reading just now tells us that in order to make Paul safe, he summoned two centurions to organize an escort.
所以呢这里就说为了要确保保罗安全呢这个千夫长就叫了两个百夫长来。
It's not just a simple escort, it is an escort of heavy infantry, cavalry, and spearmen.
不单单是一个很普通的保护那个保罗，而是呢有很多的步兵、马兵，还有长枪手。
You know this Roman governor is not taking any chances.
这个罗马兵呢不是随随便便的。
He commanded an army of 470 men.
这罗马的政府呢不是随随便便，他有470个人来保护
保罗。Riding with them 470 horsemen.
70个马兵。
What an extreme measure, isn't it?
这个非常的很壮观。
In Chinese, we 讲夸张哦。
很夸张。
哇 470 with horsemen, and you know, against only 40 people, come on.
470个人，其中是70个马兵的，是要对付40个人。
Not only that, Paul was given special treatment.
不单单是这样子呢，保罗还有他特别的待遇。
If you kind of read about the Roman Empire, criminals and prisoners will have to walk with the cohorts.
就我们看到呢，其他的那些囚犯呢，他们其实必须要走的。
And in chains.
是要被绑着
锁链。But they say for Paul, please prepare him a special horse so that he can also ride with the commander.
可是呢，对保罗来说呢，却是他那个千夫长吩咐呢，一定要准备牲口，叫保罗骑上。
Suddenly, Paul became a VIP.
所以忽然间呢，保罗变成非常重要的人物。
Not very important person, but very important prisoner.
不是很重要的人物，是很重要的囚犯。
This is one of those mysteries of God.
这就是神的奥秘。
It's called providence.
神的眷顾。
You know, when we look at the scenario, it looked very glamorous, don't you think? Paul on the horse riding with these 470 men.
这个场景呢，看起来呢，哇，非常的壮观，非常的迷人。
Against for the news or the rumor of 40 men ambush，
因为听到说呢，有这个消息讲有40个人埋伏要陷害保罗。
No, for Paul, it was maybe a question in his heart: Is this going to be the end of my journey？
可是保罗在经历这一切的时候呢，可能他内心可能就会想说，这个是不是我生命中的结束呢
？Will I actually die in Jerusalem？
我会不会在耶路撒冷就死去了呢
？And I remember now the brothers in Asia was persuading me not to go to Jerusalem。
他还记得说，在亚细亚的那些弟兄姐妹呢，一而再的叫他不要去耶路撒冷。
And looks like their fear is warranted because it is coming true.
看起来呢，他们所担心的事呢，都要成真了。
My dear brothers and sisters,
我亲爱的弟兄姐妹
，Have you ever had that kind of a feeling in your life?
你的生命中有没有经历过这样的情况
？Even though you know that God will provide for all your needs,
你知道说神一定会供应你一切的需要
，You are still quite uncertain.What is coming before you?
可是你还是很不确定，不晓得接下来要发生什么事。
And it becomes even more real when you are right in the middle of that crisis of your life.
就是在你那个危机的最中间的时候，那个感觉就更真实。
You know, dear brothers and sisters in Christ, I believe many of you have that kind of moments.
弟兄姐妹，我相信很多人都有经历过这样的时刻。
And maybe some of you at home or right here.Is already experiencing right in the middle of it.
可能在家的或者是在这里的人，就现在就在尝着这样的情况。
May I present this truth to you?
让我来把这个真理告诉你们。
And that is the mystery of God's providence.
就是神奥秘的供应的
眷顾。How do I see that? Can I really see God at work?
我能够看到神的工作吗
？What Paul did not expect coming from him was this.
保罗呢，完全没有想到的。
He doesn't know how God would work against this 40 band of Jews who were so dedicated to make sure that Paul is being assassinated.
保罗呢，是完全没有概念，没有想到神会怎样对付这40个埋伏着要陷害他的人。
Maybe for the past few nights he has been praying to God, God, is this going to be your will that I'm going to finish my life here?
可能那一阵子呢，他就一直在祷告说，神啊，是不是你的旨意让我的旅途呢就终止在这里呢？
Lord, do you really have other plans for me?
你对我还有其他的计划吗？
I have done all that I could do. I've sent my nephew to the tribune.
我能够做的我都做了，我把我的外甥呢，派去找那个
千夫长。Lord, what is it going to be?
神啊，将会发生什么事
？And all he could do was just to pray, and after that, just to wait.
他所能够做的呢，就只能够祷告和等待，什么事都不能做了。
It has to be God who would have to act on his behalf.
你必须要是神来为他找出路。
If God wanted Paul to go to Rome, it has to be God and no one else.
如果神要保罗去到罗马，就必须是靠神才能把他带去罗马，没有别的人了。
Is this working out in our life?
在我们生命中是否也是这样呢
？Are we seeing the way God is leading us?
我们有没有看到神带领我们的方式
？Are we experiencing this mysterious truth called?Providence of God.
我们是否也经历到这个奇妙的经历？神的供应呢
？Sometimes I wonder, I ponder, and I wonder how I got to this point of my life.
有时候呢，我在想说，我是怎么样变啊、来到现在今天的这个程度、这个、
？Because in my life there are many times I could have done something else.
因为在我的生命中呢，很多个转折点呢，可能我就选择做了别的东西。
I remember as a young man growing up, I have my ambitions as well.
我还记得我才年轻的时候呢，在成长的时候，我也有我自己的预
想。I have certain things planned up in my mind.
我有一些的计划在我的脑海中。
But God's providence led me otherwise.
可是神的眷顾，神的供应呢？却带我去到另外一条路。
I remember even more than 20 years ago, I almost ended up as a missionary in Indonesia.
差不多20年前呢，我差一点就去到印尼去那边做宣教士了。
You know, I went to the place in Indonesia called Semarang.
我已经去到 Semarang 的那个地方。
I look at the situation.
我看看那边的情况。
I even look at the housing facilities there.
我甚至呢去看他们那边的屋子。
I even talk with the mission organization about the education of my children.
也是。跟他们那边那个宣教士的机构呢，那边有一个接洽，然后讨论我孩子的教育。
Everything almost mapped out already.
差不多全部东西都安排妥当了。
And above all was my heart. I would love to be in the Malay speaking community at that time.
在我的心中呢，其实我很向往，很喜欢在一个马来话社群的地方来服侍。
But alas, after 20 over years, I'm still in Bukit Mertajam.
可是20多年过后呢，我还是在大三角
，pastoring this humble church here，
在这个小的教会里面服侍。
God's providence we can never understand, but we must understand that the mystery of this truth is that God is behind everything in our lives.
神的供应，神的眷顾，我们不能够了解，可是我们都知道神的真理，神的计划在后面。
Well, providence will lead us in our career as well.
这一个呢，神的供应呢，也会在我们的事业上看到。
You know, in the choice of career, young people.
年轻人，你在选择你的职业的时
候。You have your likings, you have your preferences.
你有你喜欢的一些职业。
But trust me, if you trust your life and trust your life into the hands of God.
可是相信我，如果你把你的生命交托给神。
God would lead you into places you would never imagine could happen.
神会带领你去到一个地方呢，你是想都没有想到的一个地方。
No, not many of us have a blueprint of our lives, and even if we did, we realize that we are in a different place altogether today.
不是每个人呢都有他们生命中的蓝图，即使你有也好，不一定也会成真。
You know, I used to think that we have to make a lot of sacrifices following the will of God.
我以前呢一直会想法说，如果要追求神的旨意的话呢，一定要付出很多的牺牲。
No, I remember when I was growing up as a young person, and there was this story about a pastor who made a vow of poverty. 阿拉妈。
哦，我才在小的时候呢，有一个牧师呢，他还甚至立言说呢，他以后一定会贫穷。
And then I said to myself, "Wow, want to be a pastor equals to be must be poor."
所以呢，我的想法就是说啊，身为一个牧师啊，就是等于你要贫穷咯。
Maybe it was the philosophy of those days. The church keep the pastor poor while God keeps him humble.
可能那个时候的哲学，教会呢就确保牧师贫穷，然后神就能够确保他谦虚谦卑。
And you know, in my heart, in the innermost part of my heart, I love the opportunity of going, you know, travel far.
在我的心中，其实我很喜欢去远的地方。
At that time, you know, Malaysia was kind of opening to the Asia Pacific and also internationally.
那个时候呢，马来西亚对外开放。
And then at that time, I said, if I have been working in the corporate world, they will send me to places on the expense of the company.
我也想说呢，如果我在外面工作的话呢，哇，可能我的公司呢就会用他公司的钱，然后把我派去别的国家，远远的国家，哇，多好啊！
But that is the truth of God's providence.
可是神供应的真理。
I've not gone to many places, but I think I've gone to quite a number of places. Amen.
我没有去过太多的地方，可是也不少的地方。
This is the, really the mystery.
这就是奥秘。
There's also the providence of our life.
然而在我们的生命中也有神的供应。
Something that's very important. That's called marriage, right?
婚姻。
You know, God is also involved in it.
神呢也参与其中。
No, in your heart, maybe you know that God wants you to get married.
在你的心中呢，你知道神要你结婚。
For all those who are single,
那些还单身的
，there is still hope all the time.
一直都有盼望。
I remember my lecturer, one of the lecturers in SBC. She was, I think, 50 plus or nearing 60. Then she got married for the first time.
新加坡神学院、
oh, got hope,
在新加坡神学院读书的时候呢，我还记得我一个讲师呢，五十多岁的时候才结婚。
But the problem is that God doesn't tell you who.
可是问题是呢，神没有告诉你那个人是谁。
So as a young man, every good-looking girl that seems to pass your way, you hope there will be a divine message. This is the one. This is the one.
每个年轻男人呢，每一个漂亮的女生在你的生命中经过的时候，你想说，哇，就希望神会跟你说，这个人就是了，这个人就是了。
Or a wonderful lady pass by and your heart go off beat, you know?
哇，一个很好的一个女人经过，然后你的心就乱跳了。
And then she was still not the one.
可是她还不是那一个人哦。No.
Trust in the providence of God.
相信神的供应。
I would never have thought that I would go to Singapore and meet the one.
我从来都没有想过呢，我会去到新加坡去遇到那一个诶。
His providence was at play.
他的供应就在那一边。
Can we trust God?
我们可以信靠神吗
？It may come in the most unexpected way.
就是你最想不到的方式出现。
And it was so for Paul.
对保罗来说也是一样。
A cohort of 470 persons.
470个人保镖。
Escorting him to see Felix the governor.
保镖保护着他去见那个腓力斯。
And this truth of God's providence leads us to the second thought. It is an option to drive us back to God.
这也给我们看到第二点，就是来寻一个方式来引导我们回去
找神。You know, when I was meditating on this passage and throughout this week, was this heavy thought? There is always an option to drive us back to God.
其实呢，我在一直默想的时候呢，我就想整个事情，其实呢，他这些东西都会带领我们回到神那边去。
And from Paul's life here, we begin to see this truth that despite any crisis that we may go through,
在从这个保罗的故事给我们看到呢，在我们生命中不管遇到什么样的危机，
There is always that possibility and the option that it must drive us back to God.
都有那一个选择呢，让你来选择你要不要趁这个危机快点回去找神。
So this is the mystery of God's providence.
这就是神啊供应的奥秘。
You know, Paul wrote to the church in Corinth.
保罗写信给哥林多教会。
In his second letter,
在他第二本书。
And he felt so despairing actually.
那个时候呢，他非常的沮丧。
We do not know which moment of his life that he was going through at that time.
不晓得那个时候他经历了什么事。
But the Bible says in that passage that his pain was simply too much to bear.
他那个时候呢，圣经跟我们说，他的痛呢非常的重。
That he actually felt despaired with life.
他已经沮丧了，已经失望了。
You know, I was reading that few verses this week, and I was sharing in a midweek devotion.
在星期三的那个分享，我也有跟大家分享。
In plain language, Paul was experiencing what we call hopelessness.
简单的来说呢，保罗那个时候呢就是绝望
，despaired moment，
沮丧。
What then are we to do?
所以我们必须要做什么呢？
We can try our uttermost best to address the issue, right?
我们可以尽全力的去解决那个问题。
And even that, we realize it is not enough.
即使你尽了全力，然后你发现到根本于事无
补。Can you imagine your utmost best to address the issue is not enough?
你想想那个情况，你尽了你所有的能力，可是什么事都帮不到。
I think that is indeed despairing beyond any hope.
那个真的是绝望。
He said, "I carry the sentence of death." Paul said.
保罗说呢，我担当的这个死亡的死刑的那个惩罚。
I can imagine how some of us might be feeling even right at this moment or in the past.
以前或者是现在，你可能也在经历过这样的感觉。
You have a sickness that you must battle with.
你必须要征战，对跟一个病毒来征战。
You have tried all methods of medication.
什么方式的药物你都尝试了。
You have tried Asian, you have tried Western.
亚洲的、西方的。
Some even said universal.
甚至全世界的药。
You have tried the traditional and the modern and even the mystical.
传统的、现代的药方或者是那些神秘的药方，什么你都尝试了。
Yet to no avail.
可是呢，没有帮助。
You are despair.
绝望。
Or you may have a rebellious child that you constantly struggle with.
或者是你有一个很叛逆的孩子，你一直在跟他一直的挣扎。
You try to love him in your own ability.
你尽全力的去爱他。
Still, he would not change.
可是他一点都没有改变。
You try all means you know.
你说了解你所会的方式，
you、
你都尝试了。
For him.
你为他呼求祷告。
You prayed for him.
祷告为他祷告。
You send him to people to help.
带他去找那些能够帮助他的人。
Seems that it's not taking you anywhere.
可是呢，没有帮助。
You are despaired.
沮丧。
Your company went into a disarray.
你的生意，你的非常的乱。
You run frantically from to every avenue you knew.
你疯狂的去找所有的资源。
You try every resources that you can figure out.
所有的资源你能够想到的，你都去找了。
And yet the problem still hangs.Over you.
可是你的问题一直都在那
边。You are now left with no more resources.
完全没有别的资源了。
You are despaired.
沮丧了。
Your child is in a far away land.
你的孩子在别的国家。
He is facing a problem.
他遇到了一些问题。
And you long to be with him at that moment.
你很希望在这个时候你就在他的旁边。
And the COVID situation is not helping at all.
可是这个疫情的关系呢，使到你不能够去到他的旁边。
You couldn't get there.
你不能够去到那边。
And even if you get there, you are isolated for 14 days and you couldn't see him.
即使你去到那边也好，你必须要14天的那个隔离，所以你也不能够帮助他什么。
You prayed and perhaps nothing seems to be happening.
你祷告了，可是什么事情都没有发生呢。
You contacted as many people as you know and none could help.
你联络了你所认识的所有人，可是没有人能够帮到。
You are despaired.
你沮丧了。
You know, I come to realize in our struggle of faith.
我发现到呢，在我们生命信仰上的挣扎。
Sufferings, trials, crisis will drive us to two directions.
危机、考验、试验会带我们去到两个地方。
That direction is called despair or divine
这两个地方呢就是绝望或者是神
It either drives us to a sense of hopelessness or find a helper in God
要么带你去到绝望要么去找神
The problems might still be there
问题可能还会有在
But providence tells us that we can trust God
可是神的眷顾呢告诉我们说我们可以信靠他
Amen
Amen
See, this is where the mystery of God's providence is always at play.
这就是神供应的奥秘。
We can ask why.
我们可以问为什么。
But we can also ask why not.
我们也可以问为什么不呢。
We can ask how.
我们可以问怎样。
Or we can just wait and see God at work.
或者是呢，我们就等看神怎么做。
See, that is called the providence of God.
这就是神的供应，神
的眷顾。The second truth that emerged out of this passage is the purposes of God.
另外一个呢，我们就可以看到神的目的。
And the purpose of God for Paul's life.
神在保罗的生命中的目的。
That is called the mystery of God's sovereignty.
给我们看到神的权威。
In other words, God will always be in control.
换句话说呢，神一直都在掌管。
So next, from verse 26 to 35, we see the presentation of Paul.
26到35节呢就给我们看到保罗的情况
And he is to be presented before Governor Felix
他呢必须被带到这个巡抚腓力斯
And as I said it will be a turning point in the life in the ministry of Paul
这个点呢就是保罗的事工的一个转折
Because if you notice after this in the later chapters Paul will be facing Roman rulers
过后呢，我们就可以看到保罗呢所面对的人呢，就是那些罗马兵了。
His dealings with the Gentiles was really, you know, expanded in Asia.
在亚细亚呢，他在那个地方，他的宣教呢已经传给很多的那些外邦人了。
And his ministry with the Jews was not exempted.
他对帮助那些犹太人，其实也没有，也已经帮助了。
And now he's going to, you know, put himself in a situation before.Roman rulers.
所以现在呢是另外一个对象群
Is it the sovereignty of God works like this?
神的权威的方式是
Can the evil of man work out the good intentions of God? That is called sovereignty.
人的邪恶呢能不能带出神的美好呢
Sovereignty of God tells us can tragedies turn into triumph?
神的权威呢给我们看到呢一个悲剧能不能变成一个得胜呢
So we see this truth at play
我们看到这个真理
You know we are very familiar with this promise or this verse in Romans 8:28-29 One of my favorite verse actually
我们都很熟悉罗马书第八章第二十八到二十九节
It says all things will work out together for good to those who loved him who are called according to his purpose that we might be conformed to the image of his son
我们晓得万事都互相效力叫爱神的人得益处就是按他旨意被召的人，因为他预先知所知道的人，就预先定下效法他儿子的模样。
No, I keep on rehearsing this truth so much, I actually memorize this verse very well.
我一直在读这一节，直到我都背起来了。
And because it is about the sovereignty of God.
因为这就是神的权威。
Where we don't see, God is still at work.
当我们没有看不到的时候呢，神还是在工作。
Even though we do not know and we couldn't see it.
我们看不到，我们也不知道，可是神还在工作。
There was Jesus.
那就是耶稣。
You know, lately I don't know who sent that video to one of my WhatsApp called the song "There Was Jesus."
我不晓得谁send 给我一个在 WhatsApp 那边 send 给我一首歌，就是说那里有耶稣，那是耶稣。
And finally, I found that the song was sung by Zach Williams and Dolly Parton.
不过我才知道说是 Zach Williams 和 Dolly Parton 唱的。
And Zach Williams also went through a very hard, a difficult patch in his life.
Zach Williams 呢，在他生命中也是经历过非常的艰苦的一段时间。
And he even sang a solo piece.
他也独唱了一段。
And I've been singing that song.
我有唱那首歌。
You know, time and time again in that home, my wife was saying, "Oh, that's too high, that's too low, that's just right."
时不时的，我一直在唱这首歌。有时候我的太太就会说，哇，你唱的太高了，你唱的太低了。啊，这个音还不错。
I said, "Doesn't matter. There was Jesus, right?"
我说没有关系啦，我主要的是有耶稣。
You know, and it's really beautiful words. I wish I can sing that song.
哦，他的词写得非常好。
So if those who are country western singers learn that song and sing it here,
那些唱那些像这样类型的歌的话，
But how is this truth being seen?
可这个真理怎样给我们看到呢
See the Old Testament we see it. It is written in this statement.
在旧约里面给我们看到
You meant it for evil, but God meant it for good.
旧约里面说曾经你们的意思是要害我但神的意思原是好的
Who are you thinking of?
你想到谁
Yes.Joseph of old.
约瑟
You see, he saw the sovereignty of God at work even though he went through a lot of sufferings.
他呢经历了很多很多的受苦可是他却看到神的权威
He suffered the betrayal of his brothers.
他经历了他的、兄弟的出卖
He suffered the exploitation of his ex-master.
他以前的、主人呢陷害他
He suffered, you know, a forsakenness but in the prison by his good friends.
监牢里面的人家都遗弃他。
He suffered one after another in a series of events.
一而再的很多的事情。
And yet, emerging out of this, he could still say that statement, "You meant it for evil, but God meant it for good."
可是呢，经历了这么多过后呢， you know, 他却能够说，从前你的意思是要害我，但神的意思原是好的。
When I think of Joseph, I think it's very hard to live up to his name.
我觉得呢，要活出好像约瑟这样呢，非常难。
Blessed are those who have the name Joseph. Anyone Joseph here?
那些名叫约瑟的人有吗？
呀呀 ，Joseph Tan，
有 Joseph Tan。
Man 好啊 ，Tan 那尼古啊。Joseph is a wonderful name.
约瑟这个名字很好。
Because he knew the sovereignty of God.
因为他知道神的权威。
And then we see in our Lord Jesus Christ's life as well.
过后我们也看到，在我们耶稣，我们救主耶稣的生命中也看到。
In Jesus Christ, His Son.
耶稣基督神的儿子
God transformed the greatest tragedy of history
神呢把这世上最大的悲剧
The worst murder on Jesus Christ
最残忍的、谋杀
Into the greatest triumph of human history
变成了人类最大的得胜
The resurrection of his son
耶稣的复活
And the salvation of the world
世界的救恩
My dear brothers and sisters in Christ
弟兄姐妹
This is the mystery of God's sovereignty
这就是神权威的奥秘
My dear friends
弟兄朋友们
I urge you to investigate these truths
我恳求你去来研究这个真理
Can you imagine the death of Jesus Christ brought about a greater good?
你想想神的耶稣的死呢带来了更多的好处
That you and I, if we put our trust in Jesus Christ, will be forgiven.
你和我把我们的信靠放在耶稣身上的话呢我们的罪就被得赦
Where on earth can you find forgiveness of the sins that you have committed?
你在世界其他的那一方哪里能够找到你那个罪能够被赦免呢
And have the confidence to face God.
以致到你呢能够有这个信心是能够面对面跟神的
It happened when our Lord Jesus Christ took the penalty of our sins on the cross
这样的事情会发生就是因为耶稣呢代替我们死了
If you have not come to the Lord Jesus Christ
如果你还不认识耶稣
Come
来
Come and experience the grace and the love of God
来经历他的恩典和他的爱
And then here we see the life of Paul
过后我们看到保罗的生命
The turn of event would cause him to face the Roman rulers and ultimately before the emperor
这个故事的、转折呢就使到他能够去见到凯撒
This is the first of many trials because we're going to hear later on the different kinds of hindrances and barriers that would try to stop Paul in his ministry
这个刚才我们读的呢只是保罗过后还有很多很多的挫折跟危机的开始而已
This is not going toBe the last of the death threat.
这个不是他最后一次的、死亡的威胁。
That is still coming.
还有很多。
So hold on until we reach there.
所以大家、拭目以待。
But the point is this.
可是重点是
，whatever evil that is imposed upon the life of Paul will turn out to be good.
在保罗身上的所有的邪恶 的事情发生呢，都会变成好的。
Amen.
Amen.
You want to say Amen?
Amen.
You can shout through the mask, Amen. No, this is where our faith is being challenged as a disciple of Jesus Christ.
身为耶稣的门徒，这就是我们信仰的一个挑战。
So today,
所以今天
if we are willing to trust God,
所以如果我们愿意信靠他
our trials, our sufferings
我们的试验，我们的受苦。
They may not seem to be seen as something good at this moment.
在现阶段来看呢，并不像是什么好事。
Even to a point of being despaired.
甚至到到沮丧的情况。
Trust that God is achieving a greater good.
可是可以信靠他，神他有更好的计划。
Are we driven to despair, or are we driven to the divine?
所以你是趋向绝望。还是趋向神呢？
So take home with us these two simple truths.
所以你回去的时候就带着这两个真理回去。
The providence of God.
神的眷顾供应。
The providence of God.
神的供应眷顾。
It can happen at the most unexpected time in the most unexpected way.
就是在你最预想不到的时候，以最意想不到的方式出现。
Can you say to your neighbor the providence of God?
跟你旁边的说神的眷顾。
Those at home say to whatever family member you are with the providence of God.
在家的人你就跟你的家人说神的供眷顾。
The second truth.
第二个真理。
The purposes of God.
神的目的。
Say to your neighbor again the purposes of God in your life.
再一次跟你旁边人说。神的旨意。
Those at home say to your to one another the purposes of God in our lives.
在家的你也可以跟你的旁边人说神在我们生命中的旨意。
That God is sovereign and His purposes will be fulfilled.
神是权威的，他的旨意一定会成真。
Amen.
Amen.
Young people,
年轻人
，This is the challenge laid before you.
这是摆在你面前的一个挑战。
Because there are many years ahead of you.
因为在你的面前呢，还有很多年。
People like us have already three quarter the way, left one quarter only.
像我们这样的人呢，我们已经走了人生的三分之二了。
For you, you have only just passed one quarter. You got three quarter more to go.
啊，你的话呢，就还有三分之二。
And I hope you will remember these two simple truths.
所以我希望你能够记得这两个真理。
Because with this truth, you know, embracing your life.
因为如果有这两个真理在围绕着你的生命。
You will look back and think, "Wow, what an experience in life that I never imagined would happen."
你就会回首看的时候，你就想说，哇，这个是当时我想都没有想到会发生
的事。Remember the truth in the God's word that says that I can entrust my life to God, pray to God, and God will hear me more and beyond more.
他们圣经里面就说呢，我可以把我的生命交托给他，我可以信靠他，因为他会听，然后他会。做得更多。
Young people, can you say amen? Those 30 and below.
三十岁以下的，你可以说 amen.
Hello, amen. Oh, only two people 30 and below. The rest all very old.
只有两个是三十岁以下的。
Hello, amen. Ah, now I hear more. Praise the Lord. Take this challenge.
所以担起这个挑战。
For those who have only one quarter left.
是那些还剩下三分之一的。
God is still not finished with you yet.
神还有计划，对你来说还有计划。
Amen. Oh, now you got more people who are 30 and above.
比较多是三十岁以上的。
So may God bless you.
愿神祝福你。
With this question,
以这个问题
，Where am I driven to?
你往哪里去
？Despair?
是往趋向沮丧吗
？Or to the divine?
或者是走向神
？Let us pray.
我们一起来祷告。
Lord, we thank you for this simple truth.
主，我们为了这个简单的真理感谢你。
But they are powerful and everlasting truth.
可是却是非常强大能有大能的，而是永恒的真理。
And I pray that it will penetrate into every aspect of our life.
我们恳求让这个真理能够穿透在我们生命中的每一个层面。
Because in the midst of that difficult struggle,
因为在这痛苦的挣扎的当中
，help us to see this truth.
帮助我们，让我们能够看到这个真理。
Help us to experience Lord your presence.
能够经历你的同在。
And see the promises of your word being fulfilled, O God.
能够看到你的那个应许能够成真。
Bless your people, I ask.
主啊，就是祝福你的子民。
In Jesus' name.
奉主耶稣的
名。Amen.
Amen.
Let me bring to you the announcement for this week before we close.
我们来看看这个星期的报告。
Kindly take note that there will be the prayer meeting on a Thursday night at 8 o'clock via Zoom.
这个星期四呢，透过这个 Zoom 的视频呢，会有祷告会。
And let me just make an announcement about the prayer meetings.
我们来做一些报告，讲
到这个祷告会。The leadership have decided that we will continue with our prayer meeting via Zoom.
领袖们呢决定我们还是会继续透过这个视频来祷告
But once a month
可是一个月一次
We will come and have a physical meeting
可是我们会来到教会来、一起祷告
And when we come it will be an 8:30 meeting
如果我们来到教堂祷告的话呢就是八点半开始
And it will happen on the third Thursday
就是
Am I correct?Yes, the third Thursday.
第三个星期四
Now, the third Thursday is now dedicated to praise and worship and ministry.
哦，第三个星期四的祷告会呢，就是一个敬拜的一个祷告会。
And there will be a time of ministry of healing or whatever needs that we have.
也还有一些为医治那些为医治祷告的。
I think many of us are missing the physical worship together.
也很多人呢，其实都很想念那个在一起敬拜的那个时间。
So do come, remember the third. But the rest of the prayer meeting we will still via Zoom.
第三个星期四的祷告会，其他的都还是会在这个视频。
Once every 3 months,
每三个月一次。
When we pray for the unsaved,
我们为那些还没有信主的人祷告的时候，那些还没有信主的人。
That will be the fifth week if there is a fifth week.
就是第五个星期四。
We will also have a physical meeting.
我们也会来到教会来。
So is that okay? Is that good? Wonderful. So hope to see you at prayer meetings. Do continue to pray.
所以希望在祷告会能够看到你，请大家继续祷告。
Next, no more now. Oh, okay. Then the offering will continue to be online as well as a box. There will be no bags passed around.
奉献呢，还你可以上网奉献，或者是后面有个盒子，你可以把你的奉献放在里面。
Now, if you all are aware, I hope that you have also watched the Thursday launch of the 40 days prayer and fasting.
我希望呢，你有看到那个40天的禁食祷告的那个视频。
Now, if you have not watched it.Go ahead and watch it because it's still on the YouTube.
如果你还没有看的话呢，我鼓励你去看，因为在 YouTube 还是可以找得到。
I think it's a very good video.
我觉得是一个非常好的一个视频。
There are simple people, the people who pray for the nation.
那些为国家祷告的人。
And the chairman, Reverend Dr. Yu Hon Sing, shared a devotion, a short devotion.
那个主席呢也分享了一个的灵修祷告，灵修。
And he exhorted the church.
他也呼求教会。
To think of three things.
想三个东西。
One, say choose wisely.
这好有智慧的来
选择。Choose wisely to be a church and a Christian that is commanded by God, like the seven churches.
就要选择成为一个教会呢，是被神来称赞的教会。
Secondly,
第二
he said a corrupt church cannot speak to a corrupt nation.
一个贪污的教会呢，不能够为那个贪污的国家祷告。
And then thirdly, he says, being conquerors, those who overcome will then hear the voice of the Spirit.
他说第三呢，就讲说你要成为得胜的人。
So three C's for you to remember: choose, corrupt, and conquer.
所以有三个 C， 在英文里面有三个 C。
So I hope that you'll be thinking about it this week. The care groups getting together. Come, join us in the care group via Zoom. And in the care group, we'll be discussing these three issues relevant to our life.And our church.
这小组呢，你也可以讨论来这三个方面，关系到我们自己，跟关系到教会。
And then every week, Pastor Long King will come up with questions for discussion based on the 40 days prayer and fasting.
每一个星期呢 ，Pastor Long King 呢都会从那个四十天祷告的那个禁食祷告的那个手册里面呢，问一些的问题，我们一起来讨论。
If you need the booklet, the PDF format booklet is available online, so get hold of Grace or any of the leaders; they can send it to you.
所以，如果你想要那一本书的话呢，你可以去找 Grace， 他们已经有了 Grace， 或者是其他的领袖，他们都有，他们可以 send 给你。
That's all. Let us all rise to our feet.
这就是所有的报告，请大家起立。
Let us pray.
我们一起祷告。
And now may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of our Heavenly Father, the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. 愿主耶稣基督的恩惠，上帝的慈爱，圣灵的感动，与你们每一家每一个人同在，从今直到永永远远。Amen.
Amen.
May God bless you. Have a wonderful week.
愿神祝福你，有一个美好的一个星期。
Remember God's providence, God's purposes.
记得神的眷顾，神的旨意。Thank you.